Welcome back guys. So in this video I'll be showing you how you can run the Snapdragon 865 plus processor in ROG Phone 3 at 3.1 GHz without using the aeroactive cooler. The process is fairly simple. We just need to tweak some parameters in the armory crate. I'll be also showing you how you can set the display of ROG Phone 3 at 160Hz. So I'll just open the armory crate. Here you can add any app or game. You can see it's Daemon PS2 Pro Emulator. Other apps are also present here as well. I'll run a game using Daemon PS2 emulator. Just tap on scenario profiles here and under performance mode, just tap here. You can see these are the different options. I'll select hardcore tuning. And you just need to adjust these parameters. You can see here I have set the CPU and GPU parameters to high. By default, these parameters are set to low. Just set them to high and you can see temperature control has been set to medium. It's the upper limit of the temperature at which the phone starts to throttle in order to reduce the heat. I've set it to medium. Now it's advised that your room's ambient temperature is not on the higher side. I have switched on the AC and temperature has been set to 25 degrees Celsius. Before setting the display at 160Hz, I'll just warn you about it. Use it at your own risk. Asus has not advertised the 160Hz display mode for this device. I did use the 160Hz refresh rate mode for about 2 to 3 hours, did not observe any glitches, but they haven't done any color calibration for it and the colors were looking off. The 160Hz mode information was provided by XDA. First we need to enable the USB debugging mode of ROG Phone 3. To get access to that setting, we need to enable the developer mode of ROG Phone 3. Go to system settings, then tap on about phone, then tap on software information. Then continuously tap the build number until you see a message here that you are a developer. You can see I am already a developer. So go back under system settings. You'll see this option, developer options. Tap on it. Just scroll down. You can see here I have checked the USB debugging mode. Now I'll move on to my PC. Alright guys, so first we need to set up Android debug bridge, that is ADB, on our PC. You need to download the ADB zip file. I'll give the link in the description. You can see the tutorial on XDA website. After downloading the zip file, just open it. I have created a folder in C drive. Its name is ADB. I have extracted this platform tools folder in this ADB folder. Just open this folder. Now press and hold the shift key and right click on any of the white empty space. On Windows 10, you'll see this option, open PowerShell window here. On previous Windows, command prompt option should be here. Just click on it. Now just type ADB devices. I haven't connected my phone to my PC, so it hasn't been detected. Now make sure your phone's USB debugging mode is activated and then connect it to your PC. Set it to file transfer mode. A prompt will show up on your phone to allow or deny USB debugging access. Just allow it. Now I'm going to connect my phone to my PC. I'll run the command now. You can see my phone has been detected. Now we are going to run that ADB command. I'll paste this command in the description of the video so that you can copy it from there. Now just hit enter. Now you can disconnect your phone and restart the phone and then open the display settings. Under refresh rate setting, you should be able to see 160Hz mode. Now we can disable this mode as well. Let me show you that command. This is the command. Just hit enter. Now you need to restart your phone and 160Hz mode will be disabled. Alright, so after running that command, I have restarted my phone. Now let me just show you the refresh rate settings. Go to display, tap on refresh rate. Here as you can see guys, 160Hz mode has been unlocked. I'll just select it. You can see the color has become very soft. I'll just tap on splendid. These are the display modes. You need to calibrate the screen again. So I'll just saturate the colors. Yeah, now it's looking decent. I'll stick with the cooler color temperature. Now let me just run Real Racing 3. This game runs at an unlocked FPS. So we'll see if the phone can sustain 160 FPS. And you can see the race has started. And we are getting 160 FPS. This is just amazing. Asus may unlock this mode with an update. later in the future. But I have to say guys, there is really not a very big difference between 144fps and 160fps, at least in terms of a mobile game. It's entirely up to you. The procedure is very simple. You can see GPU utilization is around 60%, 67%. This phone's battery life is also amazing. I haven't attached the aeroactive cooler, and you can see our clock speed is around 3.09 GHz. So guys, the length of gameplay video here. I hope you found it useful. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.